Hi, I'm Jason Weinberger, conductor of the Waterloo Cedar Falls Symphony, welcoming you to another episode of Music Makes Me, our series for curious young listeners. Today, you're going to get to know our violist, Kathleen Sihler. Now, I've known Kathleen for a really long time, and I'm always so inspired to work with her. So I thought for this series, I would ask her what music inspires her. And here's the answer.
Hello, my name is Kathleen Sihler. I live in Cedar Falls and I am a member of the Waterloo Cedar Falls Symphony. I've played with the symphony for almost 30 years at this point, so a big chunk of my life. I feel really lucky today to talk with you about how music makes me feel inspired, even after 30 plus years of being a violist. For me, playing my instrument and making music with others to the best of my abilities is really about sharing the emotions and the imagination that I find in music. That's really how music inspires me. My music making tool is my viola. Here she is. This is my special wooden box. It looks pretty simple actually, but can do amazing things. A viola is the middle sister in the string family. And the piece of music I'm sharing today, called Fantasia, or Fantasy, was written only for string musicians. And it feels like a real gift from the composer that he really understood the color and the power of the string family. And I always feel kind of spoiled when I get to play this piece because it's all about being a string player. This piece inspires me because it's filled with opposites. There are these incredibly powerful, big, swelling, sweeping points in the music. They feel almost like a storm in the ocean. And then there are these very private moments when just one or two string players are playing. And those feel more to me very peaceful and almost prayer-like. So the short bit you heard at the beginning today is one of these private moments. So you hear the solo viola and the solo violin playing as a team. And the music there really inspires my imagination. I hear the high violin as this soaring bird, kind of peaceful above. And then this very satisfying dark and chocolatey sound of the viola that's growing underneath, kind of going from low to high, sweeping the music forward. As a violist, it's very rare that we get these little solo moments. So I always feel like this piece is a gift, especially for me as a violist. And I feel this sense of pride and excitement that I get to share the sound of the viola with the audience. That doesn't happen very often. In the orchestra, we normally are not the showy members of the team. We're kind of like the backup singers. We're there to help keep things together and knit well together. But this is a unique time to get to share the viola sound. So let me give you a guide to this solo. As this music builds from low and high to high, to me it feels something like it's trying to bloom or grow up out of the ground. So I'll get my bow. This is just a stick of wood with horse hair from the tail of a horse attached here at the end. And these are the tools I use. So this solo, we kind of get three starts before it can really take off. So low to high at first, it's very simple. And then the second time, he changes a note to make it darker. You'll hear that in the fourth note. And then the third time is more complicated, it's a little fancier, and the music really takes off from there and swells. It'll start like this. So now I'm going to play the whole solo for you that leads us back to the full string orchestra. So when I stop playing, you have to imagine that there are 40 or 50 other string players here in my living room carrying us forward as kind of towards the end of the piece when the last waves of sound kind of fade away. Excerpt. And when I play music like that, I feel inspired by the chance to share those colors and those sounds with the audience. I feel inspired to feel that I'm outside of myself, I'm carried away to another world or another location or another mindset, and I'm inspired to have a chance to create that music live with my fellow musicians and colleagues on stage. When I last played this piece on stage with the symphony, we had special guests with us, high school players from Waterloo and Cedar Falls who were joining us for the very first time. And that was a different type of inspiration to get to share the beginning of their musical journey with this piece, that they could feel those waves and those emotions and those colors that comes from this wonderful fantasia. I hope you feel today like we have been kind of side by side here in my living room as I've shared how music inspires me. It inspires my imagination and my emotions. And every musician has their own journey with their music making. So as you listen to other episodes in this series, you'll hear from Claudia and Jason and Kramer and Anthony about how music makes them feel. So for now, take care, stay healthy, and find your own inspired spark with music. Just go for it.